Hi, Internet.
Hi.
My name's Perry, and I'm here with Morgan C.
Hello.
I should have made this video yesterday, because it was Saturday, but
okay.
I wasn't feeling very happy, so I couldn't. So, I'm making one today.
Yeah.
This week's topic is my topic, and it is, what advice would we give to cis people who want to empower trans people? What should we ask them to avoid, and what makes us feel empowered? And then the bonus question is, what is the best rainbow you've ever seen? So, as usual, Morgan, do you want to start with the bonus question?
Yeah. Well, there's been a couple times where, I guess they're more like sun dogs, I think they're called, where there's a rainbow that's a circle.
What?
Yeah, I don't know. They're
that's
really
amazing.
Small. It's like, I've seen them in winter a lot. In Saskatchewan.
Wow.
But it's like, I don't know, some sort of optical effect that has something to do with the humidity / angle of this. I don't know, whatever.
That's amazing.
It's not totally a rainbow. It's like more of like, it's like a lens flare, but in the sky, in your eyes.
Yeah.
So I see those sometimes, but I can't remember a specific moment. Mm. Although I remember, actually, sorry, I'm going to tell another story. Forget about the sun dogs. This one time I was like super depressed. This is grade 12. It's raining and I was like so upset with life and shit, and I was driving this vehicle and I turned around a corner and the sun came up behind this cloud and there's a rainbow, and I was like filled with the glowing grace of God at the moment. I was like and it felt like everything was going to be okay.
Oh,
it was
nice.
Really, yeah, I still remember that moment. I was like, I don't know.
That's nice. Mine was actually a few weeks ago. It rained just a little bit, and then there was a huge rainbow. My roommates and I went and stood on the roof of our building, which we're not allowed to do, but we did. And it was actually a double rainbow, and it was like right over this church in our neighborhood. It was amazing. And the other best rainbow I've ever seen.
Oh my goodness.
Is this rainbow.
This also answers bonus question from last week, which is the best use of sequins.
Yeah, very much. A trans woman named Dynasty gave this to me when I was at a trans camp in Nova Scotia, and she's from PEI. So maybe I'll continue to wear it in Dynasty's honor.
I'm going to continue to wear this cat.
This is Milo.
That's an accessory.
The genderqueer cat.
Aw, Milo.
The gentlest cat you've ever met.
Yeah,
I
think so.
So when I came up with this question, I again was thinking about school, because it's a horrible social situation for me at school, and I'm particularly upset these days because at the beginning there was this one cis queer dude in my class, and right away he wanted to be my best friend, you know? But I've slowly pushed him away, and now we like don't really talk. For a few reasons, like one, like he comes from a super rich family and makes fun of homeless people a lot, which I think is really shitty. And I don't want to be affiliated with that. And the other is because like I allowed him to add me to Facebook, so he knew I was trans. And one day, I don't know why, like if like it's a bad translation or like. He just didn't get it, but he sent me a Facebook message with just the word girl. And I don't know if it's because he was like, girl, and he had heard that from around, and he thought it was something that, like, gays do here or something, but, like, oh, it was really awkward, and when I wrote back, I wrote, like, you know, what the fuck, and he just, like, wrote LOL. So I think, like, he did it.
Yeah.
I don't know why he did it, you know? But, like, he also would never...
But was that in response to something else?
No. Out of nowhere. And it sucked because he was the only cis person in my class who knew I was trans.
Yeah.
You know, everyone else just refers to me as a girl, right? So, I don't know, like, from him, like, what I really wanted when I disclosed that to him was to, like, you know, stand up for me sometimes, or, like, you know, like, check in, ask how I'm doing. Like, it's just really small things. Like, really, really small things make a huge difference. Like, if someone's making fun of me... like, ask them not to. or like have my back or like affiliate with me while like everyone's quiet when I walk by them in the hall, you know? I don't know.
Yeah.
It's like if you're more invested in like looking cool and fitting in, then like that's obviously not going to help empower me, right? Because it's not cool to be a poor trans queer kid, apparently. Unless you're on Tumblr.
Criticisms.
Yeah.
yeah, I don't really... I was thinking about this topic on Tuesday when I was supposed to make a video, and I was stumped then. I'm kind of stumped now.
Yeah.
I was also overwhelmed a little bit by the fact that it was Trans Day of Remembrance, and I felt like if I had to make a video that day, I also had to address that, and I didn't have anything profound or worthy of it to say, because it's important, but I'm not really adding anything to it. But talking about it, so I was a bit overwhelmed both by the topic and by the
alignment. Remembrance. Maybe yeah, we should have had a question about that online because everyone has so many different feelings about it.
Yeah, and it is, I guess, Trans Awareness Week. Maybe it's Sunday, so maybe it doesn't count anymore. No more awareness for anybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know, like, I guess I don't have a lot to say on this topic, even though it's my own. I just, like, because it's hard to, like, I just wish that, like, what I really want is, like, just people to check in with me and just ask me how I'm doing, you know, when they know I'm in a hard situation, or, like, you know, ask me what situations I would want them to stand up for me in, and ask me what situations I need them to back off from, or, like, just, like, when I am up against someone who's treating me like shit, just maybe, like, give me the benefit of the doubt and, like, have my side unconditionally. Because there are so many times where cis people, like, start having your back, and then all of a sudden, at the end of the argument, like, they've switched over to the, like, sissy's fucking side. And
you're
like,
being mean,
I'm being, yeah. I'm at school, like, this is the biggest thing. Like, I'm a cold-hearted bitch, you know? Like, I'm mean.
Yeah.
But it's just because they're always making fun of trans people and queer people and homeless people and junkies. And, like, they don't understand how, like, I embody way too much of that shit to, like, be friendly. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. But, yeah.
So, yeah. Not... So, checking in. We'll re-go over things. Not outing people is probably a good thing to add.
Not sending them Facebook messages with the gender they were assigned at birth.
Yeah, vague weirdness about genders.
Yeah.
Just also, probably not, like, Facebooking them with every single, like, oh, there's a trans person on television. I know a single trans person.
Yeah.
Did you hear there's a trans person on the internet?
This guy at school did that, too. He brought up, like, trans people... in Iran, because he's from Egypt and lived in Saudi Arabia and spent time in Iran. So he's talking about trans people in Iran, and there were a bunch of, like, people at the table who didn't speak English. So he was like, okay, Jesse, like, your turn to explain this to everyone in French. And I was like, why would you do that to me? Like, why would you bring up transness and then make me explain it in French to all these people when I'm obviously the other? Like, fuck. Like, I don't know.
I guess, in a way, like, that's totally fucked up, like, for, like, putting you on the spot and being, like, bad timing. But in other respects, like, letting trans people tell their own stories and their own experiences and that is really probably better than making a bunch of weird shit. I don't know. Maybe it's hard. It's just people should understand stuff, but... they shouldn't expect us to explain it all the time.
Yeah.
But at the same time, they should listen to us when when we have stuff to explain.
Yeah. When we take the time to explain it, because it's hard to want to explain the same thing over and over again, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
It's exhausting.
Tiresome.
Yeah.
That, and finally, when you write a movie about a trans woman, you should cast a trans woman as your protagonist.
Mm-hmm.
And then also...
and not Chloe Sevigny.
Yeah, not Raquel Welch.
Yeah, not fucking Hilary Swank. Not fucking...
Yeah,
just give us some jobs.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, exactly.
With